Ever wonder how your paycheck reaches your bank account? Or what happens when you swipe your credit card? Thank you for joining me today. We're going to go a little deeper into payments today and understand how payments actually work. So hopefully we'll be able to understand the complexities involved in payments. Today I'm going to discuss three main topics. The first one is how payments affect our daily lives. The second, how payments actually work. And the third one, the current problems in payments today. Let us look at this from the perspective of an individual. As an individual, we get our paychecks, then we have bills to pay. These could be, for example, your utility bills. Further, you could have some smaller value payments. You go to a restaurant, use your credit cards, or you go online, again, you use your credit cards. So essentially, there's a lot of activities in your daily life that are impacted by payments. Let's get into the next part of how payments actually work. Let's say that you swiped your card at a grocery store. At one, there is you, the person that holds the card. There is the merchant processor. This is the machine that you actually swipe the card in. There is Visa, MasterCard in the middle. There's also the bank that issued you the card. So the grocery store is the one that's giving you the goods. So eventually the money has to reach the bank account of the grocery store. But this is at a very minimum, there are four people involved in this chain of events that has to happen that will eventually result in money moving from your bank account into the grocery store's bank account. This is where I'm going to introduce the concept of what's called a payment rail. In the US, there are three main settlement rails. The first one is the interchange rails. The second one is the ACH rails, and the third one is the Fedwire or the RTGS rails. Now that we covered the first two topics, let's get into the last one. So what are the problems in payments today? The first one is delays. Now when we looked at the credit card example, from the time you swiped your credit card, it takes about 2 to 3 days for the merchant to actually receive his payment. The second problem in payments is around the costs. Now in the case of the interchange charges anywhere from 2.5% to as high as 5% for the fees. So if you're a merchant and someone has come in and swiped $100 worth of transaction, you probably get somewhere between $95 to $97.50 in your bank account. So essentially, there is a cost in making these payments available to people. And the third one that we wanted to cover is the operational cost. If you're a small business or an individual, it may not be that high. You may have about 10 to 20 transactions a month, and that may not take up that much of your time. But imagine if you had hundreds or thousands of these transactions that you had to make every month. That's going to take a meaningful amount of time. So as you can see, there's a pretty significant amount of operational costs for the various participants involved just to make the payments. So to recap, we covered a few topics today. The first one is how payments affects your daily lives as an individual and as a business. Then we talked about the payment rails, how money actually moves from a source account to a destination account. And lastly, we talked about the various problems in the ecosystem. Primarily, the problems arising from the delays. The second one is the actual cost involved for making those payments. And lastly, the operational costs in terms of the processes and time that it takes in order to make these payments. Hopefully this gives you an overview of the payments ecosystem. If you'd like us to cover the interchange rails or other payments topics in more detail, please leave a comment or email us. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye.